Greetings, everyone. Pete Pardo here from Sea of Tranquility. Welcome to pick number one, my favorite debut album of all time. To me, also the most impactful debut album of all time, most influential debut album of all time. We've been doing it each and every day here this month. We've come down to the final day. Are you ready? Are you ready for my favorite debut album, the top debut album of all time? This was released May 12th, 1967. Recorded at Delane Lea Studios and Olympic Studios over there across the pond in London, England. God, we talked about Delane Lea Studios quite a bit this month, haven't we? A lot of classic albums during this time period recorded over there. Produced by Chaz Chandler for Polydor / Track Records. Are you ready for Are You Experienced by the Jimi Hendrix Experience? Yeah, that's right. I mean, it's funny because, like, the more I thought about it, you know, yeah, I had Boston yesterday, I had Black Sabbath the day before, I had Van Halen the day before that, I've had, like, Lynyrd Skynyrd and Zeppelin and various other, you know, other heavy hitters as far as debut albums go in my top 10. And when I was originally putting this list together, you know, I knew that this album would be up there pretty high, but the more I thought about it, I was kind of thinking, well, you know, I may listen to Black Sabbath more, I may have heard the Boston record more, but the more I thought about it, I was like, well, what is, in my estimation, like, not only one of my favorites, but, like, what's the greatest debut album of all time? And I kept coming back to this, and I was like, can you really top this? You know, an artist who kind of out of the gate just totally slayed everything in his path. This trio, you know, Noel Redding, Mitch Mitchell, and Jimi Hendrix, of course, you know, on bass, drums, and guitars and vocals. Not a weak track on here, and just so influential for rock guitar, blues rock guitar, studio wizardry. I mean, just, yeah, this guy just arrived on the scene and just laid waste to everything. I mean, got two editions of the album, of course, right? You know, the track list is a little bit different. It's sequenced a little bit different. But here in the States, Purple Haze, of course, kicks it off. What more can you say about Purple Haze? Again, this whole album, too, not only it's blues and heavy, it's totally psychedelic. All three of the Jimi Hendrix Experience studio albums are really, really psychedelic. Because, of course, you know, we're talking mid-late 60s here. Purple Haze, one of the great riffs of all time, great solo. Manic Depression is just so, you know, again, heavy for the time. You know, we had, like, what, Cream right before this. Cream could get heavy in spots, but nothing really like this. Hey Joe, of course, is a cover, became a very popular song. You got Lover Confusion. Man, that's how haunting and psychedelic is that tune. Just really good. May This Be Love is up next, followed by I Don't Live Today. I Don't Live Today is so good. What a good rocker. That's side one of the LP. Over on side two, you got the wonderful Swirling, The Wind Cries Mary. So good. Then from there, you got Fire. Let Me Stand Next to Your Fire. Let Me Stand Next to Your Fire. So good. Third Stone from the Sun, again, showing all these weird things that Jimmy can do with the guitar, the Fender Stratocaster, whammy bar effects, all that sort of thing. Just trailblazing, absolutely trailblazing. Foxy Lady, again, killer, heavy rocket song. And then, of course, Are You Experienced makes up the close of the album. Again, great title track. You know, and you add in some of the you know, like, session stuff. You know, you get, like, later CD releases, and you got things like Red House on here and Highway Child and Stone Free and things like that. I mean, just all this stuff that he was creating around this time just did. It's kind of unmatched, right? It's kind of unmatched. It was a new era of rock and roll being introduced here. Sure, you had Blue Cheer and The Who and The Kinks and The Stones and The Beatles and Cream, but Jimi Hendrix came from another planet. The playing field changed quite a bit here. Let's take a look at the charts. Canada, this made it to number 15. Germany, 17. Norway, number 3. UK album charts, number 2. US Billboard charts, number 5. It also hit on the R&B charts at number 10, but number 5 here. As far as certifications go, Italy, Interesting how it didn't chart in Italy, but it went gold, 25,000 units sold. UK gold, 100,000 units sold. And the United States, 5 times platinum, 5 million copies sold. You know, interestingly enough, you know, it went gold in the UK, 100,000 units sold, which is a big number for the UK. But basically, he was the one who was in the UK. He was in the UK first. He went from here to over there and just started playing the club scene. And he really made a name for himself over there before he came here. Nobody knew who Jimmy was here until he came here and played Monterey Pop, and then that was it. But, you know, he really started to kind of make things happen and get the buzz going over there in the London scene, right? So, yeah, just a fantastic, fantastic debut album that I just think is so important for not only style of music, but guitar playing in general. You know, this whole bridging together of kind of heavy rock and roll and blues and psychedelia and pop, for sure, right? But, you know, Jimi Hendrix, left-hand playing guitar player, right? Playing rock music, blues music. He's black, he's young, he's utilizing feedback and, you know, whammy bar techniques and playing with fuzz and distortion and feedback and using wah-wah pedals and Octavias and, you know, Univibes and all this stuff that he utilized. Just, yeah, just so groundbreaking. So, yeah, that is my pick for number one. Greatest debut album of all time. Jimi Hendrix Experienced. Are you experienced? Let us know what you think of this landmark album down in the comments below, as well as your pick for today. And we'll see in just a little bit. We're going to do an honorable mention separate show because I got a lot of them I want to go through. It won't be all of them because there's so many great ones. Every time I keep thinking I have my list all done, it's like I think of 5 more. So, you know, you don't want to just list every single album ever recorded. But, you know, there's a lot of good debuts, so we want to try and squeeze as many of them as we can. But we're going to miss some. So we always, inevitable, right? Always going to miss some. But if I don't mention them, maybe they aren't among my absolute favorites. And like I said, a lot of these great bands and artists got better as time went on. So maybe that debut is decent or okay, but the second album, third album, fourth album, boom, that's where it really hit the stride. So, yeah, so there's a lot of those. Anyway, starting tomorrow, we got what's turning out to be a really, really hard assignment for me. I've decided to tackle my favorite 30 drummers of all time. It wasn't that hard picking out the drummers, but then trying to pick out, like, the 3 albums. I mean, that's not too hard, but then the favorite drum performance. Again, because I tend to not listen to and isolate drumming and drum parts. So I really have to go and really start going through like songs and albums and trying to pick out those favorite drum performances. So I've got my list of 30 players. I don't have all the albums and songs yet, so I'm going to kind of be doing that as I go along, I think. I got tomorrow's all ready to go, which is good, so that's not as hard, but some of the others, I'm just kind of like, oof, how do I just pinpoint, you know? So, very difficult. I asked for it, right? I'm the one who agreed to do it. So, anyway, we'll see you tomorrow for that, starting on November 1st, but just tune in for my honorable mentions of debut albums coming up in just a little bit. Visit us on the web at www.seatranquility.org. We're on Facebook, we're on YouTube all together. All the damn time. Please subscribe if you haven't already and click on that notification bell so you get alerted of all of our content as it posts. And please do hit the like button before you leave. Also down below, get the links to our Ko-Fi page for channel donations, our merch page, our Cameo page, and the Sea of Tranquility membership options. The join button is down below. Thanks in advance for all your support there. Happy Halloween, everybody here in the States, and we'll see you soon here with more stuff. I am Pete Pardo. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.